everyone. This is Kevin Gianni from the Renegade Health Show, and today is May 8th, and I'm going to answer your questions. I'm only going to answer one question today because I think this one is so important, and it's got it's kind of a varied topic, and I want to cover it in the best I can possible and the best way for you guys to actually take action on it because it's really important. So I'm going to talk about B12 today. Spirulina is not a great source of B12 because it is not bioavailable to you. Your body cannot convert that source. So when we're talking about raw foodies or vegans or even people who are eating whole foods, we have to be concerned that we're getting the right sources of B12. Now, for vegans and raw foodies, well, we have to take a supplement. For people who eat whole foods, you can eat meat or you can eat dairy or you can eat eggs, and that will supply you with your B12. But if you are taking a B12 supplement, or for a raw foodie or a vegan who needs a B12 supplement, you've got to look at what type of chemical composition the B12 has. Now, this doesn't mean look through the internet or Wikipedia or all these different places to look at the actual structure of the molecules. We don't need to do that. It's amazing. The scientists have done it for us. There are two types, or there's actually three types of cobalamin, which is the B12 compound that you can find. There's methylcobalamin, there's cyanocobalamin, and there's hydroxocobalamin, and there's a few others, but those three are the most prominent that you'll see. What you want to look for is methylcobalamin, not cyanocobalamin or not hydroxocobalamin. The methylcobalamin is what your body actually uses for its processes. The cyanocobalamin is actually a mixture of cobalamin and cyanide, so it's a mixture. It's a more stable compound, but you know, we're not really sure what the dangers of that may be. Your body does transfer that into methylcobalamin, but not as efficiently as the methylcobalamin itself. Wow, that was a mouthful. So anyway, what I want you to do is go look in your cabinet, wherever it is, and see what type of vitamin B12 supplements you are taking. Methylcobalamin usually will be one of those under-the-tongue, sublingual type compounds. Now, the other thing that I do want to tell you is that if you're not taking a B12 supplement, you need to start taking it right now if you are a raw foodie or a vegan and you're not eating meat. I am not convinced that fermented foods are good enough to provide you with the B12 that you need. Now, what you can do, though, is that you can get a test, which is really cool. You can get a urine MMA. And what that test will do, you can get it by mail, and I'll provide some links down below where you can get it. What that test will do is it will show how your B12 is being assimilated, and if you have low B12, the methylmalonic acid levels in your body will go up, and that's what that test measures. So low B12, high methylmalonic acid. If you have regular B12, then the methylmalonic acid won't be as high, and you'll be able to see that in a test. So what better way to actually find out for sure? That's what the Renegade Health Show is all about. It's all about finding out the truth instead of guessing. I don't know how many times we've guessed, and I've done it myself. I guess all the time. But if you can get a test, you can actually see the results, and you can do it, and then there you are. You have what you need. You don't have to be in fear. You don't have to worry. You know everything is okay. So what I'm going to do is your assignment is to either find a good source of vitamin B12 or go ahead and get a test, or just, you know, really think about what you're doing. And if you don't believe in vitamin B12, I'd really consider doing one of these options. The second thing I want to ask you is your question for the day is, what episode, I mean, we're coming up to number 50 here, which is unbelievable. I want to know what episodes you like and what episodes you think we could kind of just toss away. So I want to know, as viewers, faithful viewers, I appreciate you and I absolutely love the fact that you guys spend time with us every day. What I want to know is, what episodes do you like? Do you like the question and answer? Do you like the fitness? Do you like the in the kitchen? Do you like the take action? Do you like the video essays that I do? Or which ones don't you like? Do you not like any of them? Whatever you want, I want to know what your feedback is so we can provide you with more information that you really like and that you enjoy to watch. So this is Kevin Gianni from the Renegade Health Show. Together we can change the health of the world, one show at a time. Oh wait, there's two more questions. Rob asks, who is the guy with the hippie hair? And he asks if it was me. And well, no, I'm there on the left there, and or that's the right actually. And then Anne-Marie is on the left, and that guy is Frank McKinney, frank-mckinney.com. And Frank is not only a multi-million-dollar real estate developer on the Florida coast, he actually runs the Caring House Project, which builds homes for Haitians in need. So that is just an incredible thing that he
does, and he's truly an inspiration, and I eventually want to do something similar to what he does. Second question is,
this question has no relevance to health, but Jeannie asks, why does the toilet spin the opposite direction on the other side of the hemisphere? And Jeannie, I have absolutely no idea.